Well, figure I'll get my bike ride in before the storms develop. It's hot, but not too hot for a good bike ride. I like riding my bike through the neighborhood. Do it mostly, of course, for exercise, but it's also a good way to clear my mind. Feel better about myself. It's only 1:20, so shouldn't have too much traffic or whatever to contend with. Though, as you could probably see, it's garbage day, so I gotta watch out for the garbage trucks. So here we are, still pandemicking and still fidgety as ever. I love to travel. I love to explore. Get over here. And we haven't been able to do any of this. Really sucks. Sucks for everybody, you know? This camera keeps wanting to point down. Now we want to change gears, and now it wants to point up. What is going on with this thing? This may have been a mistake. To just make a point to keep my eye on the camera angle here. Sorry about that. I don't know if my handlebar thing's coming loose. My mount. I don't know. We press on. Anyway, I do a 7-mile loop, incorporating my neighborhood and the one next to me. Usually takes me about a half an hour. And my plan is after this, I'm gonna mow our lawn, which is an hour-long feat in itself. In the midday heat. It's awesome. See if I can get it done before the afternoon storms. Yesterday the storms didn't come till late. I'm talking like 10 o'clock last night. And boy did it rain. It rained for a few hours and like heavy downpour. Another nice thing about riding through the neighborhood is you get to see what other people have done to their front yard. Get some landscape ideas. I also adjusted my wireless mic. Because the last video I made, I think it was just set too high or whatever, and so now I got it on the lowest setting, so we'll see how this sounds. So even though we're stuck with this lockdown, I can't travel to... I wanted to go to Glaciers National Park this year. Seems like a tough nugget to crack because of its location, its geographical location. Its season is very short. From everything I've read and researched, it's like you got from June till about mid-September, and that is it. And we always like to avoid the crowds, but with that kind of season, I think it's impossible. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Nobody going nowhere now. But one good thing living in Florida is there's still a lot of places within our own state that we can visit. And we still have the beach and rather decent weather, especially come fall. Couldn't imagine if I was still living in Chicago, having to be trapped like this in the winter. Nowhere to go. I don't know. It's just a bad deal all the way around. And the thing is, it's like, even if you go out, at least for me personally, I'm like in fear. Fear of touching something, fear of being around people. I try not to buy into the hysteria. I mean, I understand this is serious, you know, I get that. And I don't think it's a hoax. I don't buy into the downplay at all. But my personal feeling is this virus, though it is worse than the flu, it seems like it's transmitted like the flu, airborne. And I think if I just take the preventive measures as I would for the flu, I should be okay. Meaning, you know, wash my hands frequently and keep distance from people. I guess that's the hard part, because you don't know if you're carrying this or not. Where, you know, the flu, if you could see someone who's got cold, cough, whatever, and even if you don't know them, you're like, I'll stay away from this guy. Here, there's people that are totally unaffected carrying this. And so what seems to be someone that's harmless turns out to be a carrier, and unbeknownst to them, transmitting it. I don't know. All I know is it is what it is, and I've got to live with it until I honestly think that the hysteria is not going to die down until there's a vaccine of some sort, which I think is going to be a tough sell. I mean, they don't even have a cure for the cold, and the vaccine for the flu is even a roll of the dice. I don't know. Anyway, tired of talking about it. Tired of worrying about it. But because of these preventive measures these places have incorporated, well, I mean, I canceled my annual passes for both Disney and Universal, because with the new rules they have in place, it's not conducive to what me and the wife visit the parks for. You know, we always use them as a place to go, to go for a walk or whatever. We just jump in a car, go to Disney for a couple hours, walk around, maybe grab something to drink or a snack and people watch, you know. And now, like, Disney is making you make a reservation to get in the park, which you don't even know if one will be available, and it just got too restrictive. And I get it, you know, in this current environment they have to find a way to limit the attendance and keep the crowds down. So I guess if anything, I'm contributing to that. Whew. A little breezy. Hopefully you can hear this. So I think what I'm gonna do is the same thing I've been doing the last couple weeks, is just kind of going around to little spots here locally with my camera and take in some of the other sights and sounds in the area. I noticed yesterday when I was picking the mail up that it seems like our community pool has opened up again. That's been closed since the start of this pandemic. I was wondering about that because a lot of the other pools are open. I didn't see anything in the website for our homeowners association addressing the pool. So I think, yeah, my plan is finish my bike ride and I'm gonna mow the lawn, rest up a little bit. I think that's enough to keep me busy. My wife's working till 11 o'clock tonight, so it's just gonna be me and the dog this evening. So now I'm going back the way I came. Just past my daughter's neighborhood. The other thing that sucks is because of this pandemic, I wasn't able to see my daughter Father's Day. So hopefully we'll make up for all this later on. It's just pure craziness. I gotta be careful at this corner. Yep, just like I thought. That guy wasn't so bad. They were slowing down. You got other people, they bust right past that stop line and it's kind of a blind corner. I'm convinced that if I ever get tagged, that's where it's gonna be. So what I'm hoping with my videos is I just get progressively better with them. I'm sure the first several here are going to be crude but just shooting this nonsense, it serves as a good way for me to learn my editing software, which is pretty detailed. I use Final Cut Pro and it's got some really good capabilities. It's a matter of me learning how to use stuff. Thank God for YouTube. Gotten a lot of good pointers and advice through YouTube. So I'm hoping that I progress both my shooting style and editing, kind of find my niche, find my style. I went through the same thing with photography. Right now I'm just shooting with this GoPro. I used the GoPro 7 Black, and then my latest introduction was the Rode wireless mic, which I learned about from a YouTube video. And so far, I mean, they're handy. It's just finding that sweet spot as far as the levels are concerned. And then developing a system. So right now I have the transmitter hooked onto my collar, which is fine because it's small, but it's this, you know, this big square thing that when I'm in the frame, you can see. And I guess it's better things, something better for you to focus your eye on besides my goofy face. But for me, it's a distraction. And it bothers me every time I edit or whatever. All right, back in my neighborhood. Should be reaching the 5 mile mark here. Not many people out at all today. Of course, it's pretty common for 2 o'clock in the afternoon in Orlando, right? Who on earth would be out here when it's hotter than the blazes of hell, other than some goofy old man on his bike? All right, the last mile. Back into the wind, figures. Home stretch is going to be a challenge, but mowing that lawn is going to be even more of a challenge. Got to get it done though. With these afternoon storms, the way this grass grows, I almost need to cut it twice a week. It's not happening, but it's really what it needs. Oof, I felt that in my knees. That's the old man part I was talking about earlier. All right, home stretch. Done and done. Now it's time